pace of change has been so dramatic in IT itself, how do you prepare your IT staff? But one of the things we've been talking about is the role within health IT's, the roles are really changing from technology roles to people roles. People and understanding culture and communication. And these are all areas where if we have a, as they were talking about, you know, a 75-25 or 80-20 male to female ratio, this is areas where we can really make that transition and start adding a lot of, because, you know, STEM is underrepresented today, but that's not what we're hiring anymore.
No. We're
hiring. So what does it look like? I mean, what are we looking to do with that staff to help them make those transitions?
What I feel like people forget about, or what they say, is that people are focusing on the soft skills. It's the soft skills that women are better. It's the soft skills that are important. These aren't soft skills. This stuff is hard.
Oh.
When you need to have a thoughtful conversation, you need to be articulate. You need to know what you're talking about. You need to have the education. You need to have the background. Those are not soft skills. So leadership and communication and the ability to affect and drive change within an organization, to be a role model and beacon for others, to have a crucial conversation but do so with respect, those are tough skills. Those are the things that everybody needs to bring to the table. And so whether you're in STEM or operations or wherever you come from an educational perspective, it's having the ability to embed those capabilities into your organization, into your teammates, and create an environment where they can practice those types of skills. And it's not always going to be at the bar at 10 o'clock at night. I'm always fascinated when I come to conferences. Everyone's, you know, at the bar and people expected to go out and party. I'm like, you are never going to see me having too many drinks or staying out past 10 o'clock, because that's not where you're going to create that momentum and create an example for others to follow.
Yeah, absolutely. The thing that's, I guess what you're saying is we should start calling hard skills. And soft skills should be the things where we just sit behind a computer and create spreadsheets and
yeah.
do all that
when you
stuff.
Do not have to interact with other people, that is a soft skill.